So now you should have a main screen with a button and a screen window, and also a welcome screen. So now I have a challenge for you. The challenge is to add additional buttons and screens for the following. So to your main screen, I'd like you to add buttons with the following texts: screen windows, JavaScripting, parameter control, faceplates, plan objects, performance insight, and PI shift calendar. And then for each of these texts, go ahead and create a screen just like you did the welcome screen, and make sure that you size it so that it fits the width and height of the screen window object that you created on main. So go ahead and pause the video and create these, and then I'll show you how I did it. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and begin creating the buttons. And so on my button here, I'm just going to right click, copy, and then paste. And you can see we have our alignment lines. And I can copy both of those and paste those. So now we have four. And then I'll paste those. Okay, and then I just need to go to each one and add the text. So the first one's going to stay welcome. I'll hit my properties window. So this one is screen windows. This would be the screen where we do some labs on different uses of screen windows. The next one is going to be JavaScripting. This is where we're going to do some scripting examples. The next one will be parameter control. And this is really user archives or recipe management. And then the next one will be faceplates. And if you accidentally move something, just hit Control Z for undo. And the next one is going to be plant objects. And the next one will be performance insight. And the next one's going to be shift calendar, or you can do PI colon shift calendar like I did. So we can see here, this one, the text is a little bit too long. One thing we can do is hit shift enter, and it will give it to us on both lines. So that's a pro tip there. If you click into your text area and hit shift, and while you're holding shift down, hit enter, it gives you an extra return character. Okay, so the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to create our screens for each of these. So let's go back and open welcome. I can open it down here. And if you recall, the height is 1000 and the width is 1700. So this is already the correct size. What I can do is right click copy this, and then right click paste. It's going to add an additional screen, and it's already going to be the correct size. So here, if you look, we'll just open this up, and you can see here, this is the welcome one screen. So we're going to get rid of this stuff. So I'll get rid of the text box, and then on our background graphic, just going to get rid of that. And now we kind of have a template screen that is the correct size. Now, we don't want to leave these blank and gray, because when we get to navigating, you're not going to be able to tell you're changing pictures because they're always going to be the same. So I will rename this, and this is going to be screen windows. What I want to do is add an object or change something that tells us this is a different screen. So I'm just going to use a text box, put it up here, just as kind of a, these are placeholders until we start adding things to these screens. So I'll just call this screen windows, and then I will give it a little bit bigger font so we can see it pretty well. And then maybe for our four color, I'll just give it a different color. Okay, so there's orange, and we'll just kind of size it, and we'll hit save. So now all I have to do is on screen windows, I'll copy that, I'll paste it, And then I'll just rename this to the next thing, which is going to be JavaScripting. We'll double click to open JavaScripting. You got to make sure you do that or you're going to be changing the screen you copied. So here you can see we're on the JavaScripting screen. So I'll highlight my text here. And we want to change the text here. And if you want to, we can give it a different color. And I'm just going to continue this procedure until I have all my screens done. Okay, so now I've got all my screens created. I've got my main screen with all my buttons. Got a welcome screen, my screen windows. And since I left a space in all of these, I'm just going to go edit this and put the space back in. Also notice that for my shift calendar, I couldn't put the colon because the colon is an illegal character. But we can go through and look at all these, and these are all different screens. So the next task that we have is to do navigation. And that just means that we want to click the button and then see the appropriate screen show up over here in our screen window. So I'm going to show you how to do the first two. We'll test it out in runtime. And then I'll leave it as a challenge for you to finish adding navigation to the buttons. I'll highlight the button, and since our screen window is already pointing to welcome, then pressing this button is going to appear to have no effect if you're already on the welcome screen. That's why I'm going to do two, so that we can show that we're switching between these. So we're going to go to the welcome button, and we're going to go to events, and we're going to choose an event here. Traditionally, click left mouse button is what you use when you do something. That's traditional for Windows. When I highlight this, then it allows me to add a function. And if you do this drop down list, this is what we call our list of system functions. And they have different things. We've got alarm logging and audit trail and stuff like that. Screen, we want to do something with the screen. We have a function called change screen. It's going to ask us for two pieces of information. Number one, what screen would you like to see? And number two, how do you want to display it? So we have something called the screen window path. So let's do the easy one first. I'll just click the browser button. It's going to give me a list of all my screens. I'm going to choose welcome. Okay. And I'll just choose the green checkbox. So now we have this screen window path and it says current screen. And if we do this drop down, it'll give us the choice of either current screen or base screen. So your base screen is your primary screen. It's usually the screen that is your startup screen in your runtime settings, but you can change it. Changing the current screen is basically a way, if you have a screen window, to change that, which is what we want to do. So we're going to leave that at current screen, but now we're going to choose this menu over here, which is, you know, set your type. The screen name is going to be shown in a screen window, or we're going to send this as a string. So I'm just going to choose screen window, and then it's going to ask me, okay, well, what string window do you want? So notice that it shows our screen window that is on this page, and because we've named it appropriately, if we had several screen windows, this would be very easy to pick out of a list. So the way that you look at this function is when we click the left mouse key, that's the event, then we're going to change the screen we're viewing. We're going to change it to the screen with the name welcome, and it's going to be displayed in this screen main window display screen window. So I'm just going to save that, and then I'm going to do the exact same thing on this screen window. So once I've selected that on my click left mouse button, I'll do add function, screen, change screen, and then now we're going to just select the screen we want, which is going to be our screen window. That's what's on this guy. And then we'll just select the type of screen window, and that's going to be this guy. So I'm going to save that, and then on my runtime module, I'm going to right click, download, only changes, and it's going to give me this extended download. And I'll just use my device name. Click connect. And load. Okay, so it's making me do a full download because this is the first time since I opened the project that I've been to runtime, and I do want it to start runtime, and I'll just click load. Okay, so it looks like everything went well. Pull up a browser. It's going to ask me to log on. And so I have all my buttons, but now if I choose screen window, it is showing my screen window screen. I know that because that's the text I displayed. And if I click welcome, then it's going to show my welcome screen. So now I have a challenge for you. I would like you to repeat those steps on each of these navigation buttons. If you've forgotten a few steps, please review the video. Go ahead and pause this video for now and complete this challenge.